Hi, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Dr. Zyrowski from NewVisionExcel.com, and in this video, we're going to discuss whether or not fasting disrupts your metabolism. You see, many people believe that if you do fasting or any type of fasting, what's going to happen is it's going to decrease your metabolism, decrease your metabolic rate, and then from there, what's going to happen is you're going to have some serious long-term weight problems. And so what we want to discuss in this video is whether or not that's even true. And then at the end of this video, what I'm going to do is share with you a very cool study that was done that shows us how we can actually increase our metabolism. Now, it's well-established knowledge that your body can go into this thing called adaptive thermogenesis. And what this essentially is starvation. And when this happens, what your body does is it decreases all metabolic activity in order to conserve energy. Now, this is a basic survival mechanism, okay? And so let's talk about there's two ways that this can happen, because one way is extremely obvious and the other way is not so obvious that many people are falling victim to. And so the first way that this can happen is through, you know, full-on starvation, okay? But this can also happen in regards to fasting if people are doing excessively long fasts. So if you're doing a 15-day fast, 20-day fast, if you're doing really long fasting, your body will decrease metabolic activity in order to conserve energy so that, you know, basically you can survive, because it will think that your body is going into this starvation period, that it just, you know, your body is essentially doing everything it can to survive. Now, the other way that this can happen that most people are unaware of is by calorie restrictive diets, okay? So to give you an example, you know the show The Biggest Loser, where they took these people and they had them lose weight over, you know, somewhat of a short period of time, and they did so by doing very strict calorie restrictive diets. And what they found after they did this study on these people is 6 years later, not only did they actually gain all that weight back, all that hard work that they put into that, all the weight came back, okay? So regardless of their hard work, you know, it was kind of done in vain because it was done improperly when it came to weight loss. So they follow these calorie restrictive diets, they lost all the weight, but they gained all of it back. And what they also found, which is very alarming, is that because they did this calorie restrictive diet for a long period of time, and they were believed to think that this is what they needed to do in order to manage their weight, what they found is that even after their metabolism bounced back quite a bit 6 years later, their metabolism was burning about 500 calories less than what someone their age should be burning. So it really disrupted their metabolism being on that calorie restrictive diet for a long period of time, okay? So those are the two ways that you're actually going to decrease metabolic activity, decrease your metabolism. Now, the good news is that there's actually fasting that can increase your metabolism, and I know that's what you've been waiting for to hear, so let's talk about that, okay? So the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition, what they did is, I mean, of course, several studies, but a couple we're going to highlight here, is they had a group of individuals do alternate day fasting, and they did it for 21 days. And what they found is it actually did not disrupt their metabolism at all. So with the alternate day fasting, their metabolism stayed steady and strong, which is really great, okay? And then another study done by the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition is where it was done where they took 11 men, and what they did is they did a 3-day fast. They took 11 healthy subjects and did a 3-day fast on them. And what they found is that their metabolism actually increased by 14%. Now, that's really huge. Now, when I, you know, talk to people about doing fasts, I typically recommend, you know, one or two ways to fast. One is to do like a 3-day fast, and the other is to do intermittent fasting, okay? Now, there's many different ways of fasting, but these ones work really well. Intermittent fasting, for instance, works really well because it spares muscle breakdown. So, you know, though you're going to be burning extra fat and you're going to be losing weight in that way, you'll find that you're actually sparing muscle breakdown, so you're not losing muscle as well. And that's why so many bodybuilders love it, so many gym goers, athletes, they all love intermittent fasting because they're able to maintain the results, but also just keep that fat off their body and stay nice and lean. So if you want to increase your metabolism through fasting, doing things such as alternate day fasting, things such as 3-day fasts, things such as intermittent fasting, those are all going to do great things for your metabolism. One of the things that's very important when it comes to fasting is that you are following a good quality diet, because if you are not following a good quality diet, you don't have good levels of micronutrients and trace minerals and all these different things that are necessary for bodily function, what can happen is when you start fasting, you can go into a deficiency in these areas. So you start fasting and you go into these deficiencies, and next thing you know, your body reacts in a strange way. So when you're doing fasting and you want to get the best results and you want to make sure that you don't disrupt your metabolism, make sure that you're following a good quality diet. Make sure that your nutrient stores are where they should be when it comes to the minerals and the vitamins and the essential fatty acids, all these things. And that way you're going to get the best results out of fasting. So until next time, folks, I hope you make it a great day. If you have any questions, go ahead and post in the comments section below. Other than that, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I will see you for the next video. Talk to you then.